All right, this is going to be another one of those one-take, two-minute kind of... Well, I don't know how long it's going to be. No editing, just a random chat. I was kind of setting up a video earlier today where I was testing. Let me just show you here. I want to start using the GoPro 7. Well, first of all, I realized that... I'm looking at the screen here. This is not how I want this lit. I kind of want to have this set up in here where it's a little bit more high tech. Some LED lighting behind me, and it's not looking like that at all. I got these drapes here. This looks awful, but anyway, we're going to come back to why I just decided to randomly start recording here in a few minutes after I talk about this. I got to give you some little piece of information. Can't just kind of drop in here and say hi and say, hey, that's it for the week. So anyway, I got this recommendation from Jevon Dovey, I believe his name is. It's an iGadgets tripod with a little attachment so you can use it for a GoPro. I have a case ordered, a new case for this, that will allow me to mount this piece here, which this may or may not be interesting to anyone, but it allows you to go into the whatever connection this is on the GoPro. It's a, I believe it's a UHB-C, maybe. Maybe not. Anyway, it will allow me to use this microphone here or the one that's on top of this camera here to get better audio into this, because to be honest with you, when I'm vlogging with this thing, it kind of sounds like you're speaking into a soup can. And it might sound like that now. The audio is not that great in here. But anyway, I'm clicking this a lot. Sorry about that. It will allow me to kind of, you know, have a smaller camera when I'm out doing some landscape photography. I'm going to have this anyway because I'm going to shoot hyperlapse, time warps, and time lapses. So I just maybe another tool for the bag, so to speak. I don't like the GoPro's... I kind of like this tripod, actually, this little one that comes from GoPro. It's got this little extension thing here. But the problem I found when I was holding this, vlogging, it was still making a little bit of noise. So that's my half-assed video for the week. I'm working with a friend of mine tomorrow, and I don't think I'll have a chance to vlog. I didn't have a chance to vlog this week, or didn't take the time to vlog the week, or this week, but... You know, I'm going to link to a channel here from Peter McKinnon, and it was really similar to what I recorded last week, just about getting out and doing the work. He has over 3 million, I think, followers, or maybe 1.8 million. I don't know what it is. You'll see when you check it out. But he really talks about the same thing, about, you know, you may step up to the camera and may not have... You know, you may be totally out of ideas. You may have a couple of projects you're working on. I'm actually editing another video for next week, but I don't have anything now, and I know I want to release something on Sunday. And he really drove home the showing up to release something on a schedule and sticking with that, even if you're not ready for it, going through the process, because you might learn something anyway, and it really just kind of keeps you focused on what you're trying to do, what you're trying to get done. And I don't know, I know I'm not explaining it that well. He's gonna do a much better job, so I'm gonna do a link to that. If you're still here, I appreciate it. And if you are still here, go ahead and check that out. But one thing I will upload right after this, and I could piggyback it right after this video, but I think I'll do it as a separate video. I did a slideshow creation, if you would, with some video clips from a trip I took to the Apostle Islands ice caves in 2014. I wanted to go again this year, but the water's not freezing up enough to walk out to the caves. So I'll end this video with just a couple of stills from the last time I was there, and then definitely I'll put a link to that other video, or put one here. Definitely check that out. I think it's kind of cool. I used an app called Animoto, and it's a, you know, it's a cloud-based app that you subscribe to. Not cheap. I think it's $250 a month or something. And it allows you to create a variety of different slideshows. You can use little video clips and also stills. And it kind of does the magic for you. It does all the timing. You can rearrange the images. I kind of tweaked it a little bit. It doesn't take near as much time as creating a video with Premiere. But I like some of the templates and I like some of the cool effects you get out of it. So anyway, that's all I got. Check out Peter's video. Check out that Animoto video of Animoto? Animotimo? Mike, really, you're like burping. This lighting is really awful. See, I envision that being out of the picture. Maybe getting rid of this. You know, my desk is all, it's just all old world kind of brown. I have the studio over here. I could be using that. I will be. Anyway, that's all I got for today. Sorry if it was too lame. I hope you got something out of this. I'll put links to all of this stuff below. And that's it, man. Have an awesome weekend. More on all this later.